Hello, folks. This is David Erickson with the eStrategy Internet Marketing Blog at e-strategyblog.com. Today, I'd like to do a case study in how damaging video can go viral. This, of course, is a video of Mankato, Minnesota news anchor for KEYC, which was recently uploaded to YouTube, which appears to show the anchor drunk.
With the snowfall, it seems like many of feel like the Christmas season is here. And near Waseca, Farm America held its annual Christmas on the farm event. Today's event featured Christmas music, food, and a chance to meet the Santa dog. They felt three ways for Christmas, parents and
okay, so that sounds pretty damaging. The anchor herself and her station have subsequently come out and said that she was had a bad reaction to some medicine she was taking, but it was a little too late to staunch the damage. So what happened here was she had this broadcast. Somebody recorded it. A guy named Corey in Mankato. Uploaded it to his YouTube channel. This is it on the 6th of December, and the following day. So he uploaded it on the 6th of December. The following day, December 7th, he tweeted it out with a link to the video, and tweeted that out to his 40 followers. Okay, among those 40 people, it started spreading. And it spread wide enough that a site like Gawker picked it up and posted it on there. And then, sites like Gawker, Huffington Post, The Onion carried it. Those three combined alone account for 109 million visitors a month. Okay, so it gets into these sites, and then it comes to the attention of somebody like David Letterman, Letterman's writers, and Letterman uses it, of course, for his late show.
Category tonight, top 10 signs your local news team is drunk. I didn't know things like, well,
what
this
is
is
this
what
about?
happened. Miss Annie Stensrud, an anchor woman for KEYC TV, Channel 12 in Minnesota, to CBS affiliate.
Oh, yeah.
Love it. Love all these folks. Slurring her words during Sunday's newscast, leading many to believe she may have been drunk.
Oh,
may have been drunk. Now, I.
Okay, so he featured the video on his top 10 list, made fun of it, and with 3.5 million viewers per episode approximately, drove search. And so here's a search traffic of, you can see on December 7, the phrases Annie Stenerud, the anchor in question, KEYC TV, call letters, and then generic search terms such as drunk news anchor and drunk anchor are hovering around there. And then you see a big spike the day of the broadcast on Letterman. So the TV drove search, right? And then what you see in search is video, stories about the video, all the way down the line. You also see Annie Stenerud has her own YouTube channel. She's got her own LinkedIn page, so her social media is coming up in these searches. You look at YouTube searches for her name, and you get the top two links are the broadcast in question. So it's pretty damaging. Fortunately for her, she does have an online presence. She's got a YouTube channel. She's got a LinkedIn account. She's got some social media. The way you combat this is with additional content. So I'd suggest to her to create a video, optimize it for her name, discussing the issue, discussing the fact that she was on medication, apologizing, etc. But get her own content out there to combat the content that is already in circulation. At least have your voice in the if you can't eliminate the content entirely, have your voice in the among the content, so people at least get your side of the story. So this has been a case study in how damaging video can go viral of the eStrategy Internet Marketing Blog at e-strategyblog.com. When you visit, be sure to subscribe to the news feed so you get all the posts, or subscribe to my daily newsletter via email by clicking on the subscribe button.
Thank you.